of the Bud Doors here, and today we're gonna be doing some, you know, shopping, but it's not what it seems like. Today we're gonna be, actually, you know, shopping for outdoor stuff, you know, hunting and fishing stuff, and, hopefully we'll find what I need after what happened yesterday. It seems like I need, you know, definitely some good fishing stuff. No, I'm just joking. He was using a lot of stuff that I had. It was just wasn't my day. My muscles were cold. I just froze up. But no excuses, right? So let's go get some stuff. Wow, just before I came in, I got stopped by somebody really cool. So if you're that guy, just let you know that was really cool of you. I hope that you subscribe. Now that I'm in here, we're going to find some fishing stuff, you know? Something good for my next tournament. So, get back with you.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me, can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me,
an academy, and we're going to my fishing partner's house. He's got some stuff for me we're gonna pick up, and once we get back to the house, we'll see all what I got. So we got the stuff from my fishing partner's house. We stopped by Walmart, got some hooks. Now we're gonna go back at home.
To those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say.
So we made it back to the house, and let me just kind of go through all the stuff that I got. I'm gonna start with the stuff that I bought first. These flukes that I got. I got Zoom super salty fluke, blue watermelon, and sexy shad. So I'm just kind of open these up and let you have a little look. I have a kind of a salty smell to them. Kind of actually kind of smells like pool water. You know, how it has like kind of like chlorine in it. And this one, you know, so it's about the same. But I think it'll be really good. Alright, moving on. I got the H2O premium spinnerbait. It is, let's see if I can figure out how much it weighs. Obviously, as you can tell, I got, it's a double willow, and I actually kind of like that, you know, I don't know why, but I just do like, I like double willow designs, and I'll kind of, in my opinion, I think they would look more like a school of shad, or whatever, you know, little fish are swimming by. Next, I got some, Big Bite Baits 5-inch Cincos. This is in a kiwi color. As you can kind of see what they are. They're, as in the package, you can kind of tell they're salted. I got these because I think, the, you know, the color differences, you know, I think that'll really work good. You know, it's got like, it's got that light green, and then it's got this, like brown with red flake in it. And, I think that'll work really good when I'm going to use like maybe something like a wacky rig. Next thing, I got it's an H2O hollow body frog. I got this color design in particular because I really don't have anything else that like it. I have a white frog, I have a black and yellow frog, and I have, you know, a purple frog, but I didn't have anything like this, so I decided to get this color, you know. But I think that'll work real good, especially with, you know, spring coming up. My next tournament's in April, so I think definitely that'll work good, you know, around some pads and stuff, maybe even in the open water. So, next thing I got were some nail weights, and, you know, I got these for the Cincos. I could do a weighted wacky rig, just kind of work it and make it kind of flap. Next thing I got were some, bullet weights. They are steel bullet weights, you know, I really, wasn't even thinking about it when I got them, but I should have got lead. Lead is more dense, you know. But these will work fine. They are 1/4 ounce. So I got these more Cincos. I like the dark brown with the chartreuse tips. I chose those because I think they'll work really great. I like the dark and then the lighter color, like that chartreuse color. This color in particular is called Green Pumpkin Chartreuse Tip. So I also got some weighted hooks for my jerk bait, you know, and stuff like that. Then I got some hooks that, you know, you could use these drop shot. You could use these for wacky rigging. Let's see what else you can use it for. You could, like, you know, hook stuff like worms with the nose and stuff like that. But mainly I'm going to use these for wacky rigging and drop shot. And that is all the stuff that I bought, and the total came out to be like $32 total for all that stuff, which really good. I think I did really good, you know, not, you know, breaking the bank, but at the same time getting the stuff that I needed. So now I'm just gonna move on to the stuff that I got from my fishing partner. Starting with this first box, you know, he gave me a couple Shimano boxes. Okay, so he gave me this finesse jig right here. It's got place for a couple rattlers on there, but they don't have any in there. But right now it's just a finesse jig. I kind of like that chartreuse with the dark color. I think this will work pretty well underneath, you know. Get up close to the docks and, you know, in the brush and stuff. But then he got me this chatterbait right here. It's not the prettiest looking chatterbait that I got, but, you know, hey, I'll use it. It's pretty. But this is actually something I don't have, is a chatterbait with a free swinging hook. See, I like that. Definitely, I can, you know, put a nice little trailer on there and run that. It's even got, the hook has even got somewhere you can screw it in. I'll probably put a swim bait trailer on here. I like that. He also got me this chatterbait right here that comes with a treble hook. The reason why I like this chatterbait is because, say, I have like two rods, like medium rods that I'm using, using up on something else. I could put this on maybe a lighter rod and it would still work, because the reason why is because this treble hook right here, you don't have to jerk so hard to set the hook. Yeah, really most of the time if you're using a good rod, it'll almost set it, the fish really takes it, it almost set itself. So I could probably use this on a lighter rod and fish takes it, and the rod almost sets the hook itself for me. But that's why I like this one. I could use this on a light medium rod, not have to use like a medium heavy or a medium rod. Moving on. He really nothing in these boxes right here, but he just gave me this Shimano box and this little bitty box right here. And this is a box that I just left in his boat last time I was fishing with him. Alright, look into the bag of goodies. Alright, so he gave me some finesse worms and a watermelon seed color. I got plenty of finesse worms now. He also gave me more finesse worms. Alright. He gave me this rattle trap right here. Kind of has an art of chartreuse underbellies, Bill Lewis lures. I'll definitely put this to work in my next tournament. I also got some of these hogs right here. Definitely, I'll probably use this for flipping and punching and stuff like that. Last time I used one of these, I was flipping underneath the dock and trying to get in there. Also got, okay, big bag of stuff right here. So this is another, this is actually a swim bait jig right here. It's a swim jig, so got that. Whole bag of them. There's another swim bait. Swim bait. Also got more of these chatterbaits. You know, this is, I probably, in this exact color, I probably already have about three, and then it does add that one to it. Yeah, this is just a skirtless chatterbait right here. It's already got it, got a plastic on there and everything for me. More chatterbaits. I like that one. I like the head on that one. More chatterbaits. Then I got some Kickin' B-Chunk right here. White color. I already have some of these, but now I have more. You know. Can't ever have enough fish and stuff. I'm just saying. And then more finesse worms. This is a sun perch. Got some, I know I got some of these colors, but ooh, got more rattle traps. Alright. So I got more rattle traps from the Bill Lewis lures. And got that one. And this one right here. It's a chrome. Moving on. Now, a couple things that, he's, I got this, Bass Pro Shops, I think it's a Johnny Morris, it's got a 10 bearing system in it, you know. Two of those, and he also is letting me, for my next tournament, he's letting me use these rods right here. It's a Power Max 7 foot medium heavy rod. And, yeah, I use this for, like, Senko jigs, flukes, Texas rigs, and spinner baits. But definitely, I like this, thing came on so soft. It looks so weird. Anyway. He gave me that 7 foot rod right there, and then he also gave me, or just let me borrow these, two, Powells. They are a 6'3" medium heavy, you know, same use as them. You get the same use out of them. And, you know, that's all what came out of this trip today. I mean, I know this is kind of a lengthy video, but I hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and don't forget to stay pumped.